Once a fertilized egg starts to divide, it is quickly going to form the embryonic stem cells. And it is from those that every other cell in our body is going to be derived from. We end up with development of a single cell into a very complex organism. The Wnt pathway is a mechanism by which we get the expression of certain genes as the consequence of the trigger given by the Wnt to the cell. And it is a combination of the Wnt and the pre-pattern that is present in the cell that will drive the cell into making more cells or starting to differentiate into specialized cells. The Wnt pathway sends signals to cells to divide in the correct manner. One example is wound healing. They become activated by damage to a tissue, and then the neighboring cells start to divide. All of those molecules become activated locally to make sure that the wound is going to heal locally. When it comes to the medical implications of the Wnt pathway, there are two sides of the coin. One of them is cancer, overactivation of the Wnt system, overproliferation of cells, and therefore cancer. The other side is that lower than normal Wnt signaling in the tissue, that can lead to what we call a degenerative disease, bone abnormalities, developmental abnormalities in the central nervous system. This is the whole goal of human genetics, by understanding that pathway, how we can correct the defect. When I started in the mid-70s, there was virtually nothing known about cancer. And I'm very grateful that I was part of that, but in the context of an enormous worldwide effort in understanding cancer cells. You see an evolution that starting from a simple structure, you can make a more complex structure by making sure that you get different cell types, and these signaling mechanisms are instrumental in making the complexity of life as we see it now.